there, guys and girls, and everything that's in between. Welcome to another episode of Sinbad the Merchant. Last time on Sinbad, war broke out between the Serenids and the Khergits, and we were left in a pretty sticky situation in that most of our businesses in the Khergit territories were sequestrated. So what that means is that we're not going to really be making any more money anytime soon from Tulga, Ichamur, and Durkaba. Fortunately, though, Sinbad is swagged out enough that he can still be making money. And the main thing I want to do this episode is try to increase my relationship with Dibane and also start scouting around the map to see where is a good position for us to capture a castle and maybe start to grow our fiefs so that when we eventually split off from the Serenids, we can start to form our own faction. On the grand scheme of things, it's actually not looking too bad for Sinbad. The Serenids are weakening, the Khergits are becoming strong, our relationship with the Khergits is pretty good. The Rodoks are also weakening heavily, with only one city left. The Vagars have been gone for a long time. So what that means is that if we do capture a territory from the Rodoks, they're not very likely to become powerful again. And if the Serenids indeed do lose two more cities on their eastern front, it'll be very easy for us to just leave the Serenids. But before we do that, we gotta make sure that Lady Sophia is married to us. So, Lady Sophia, improving relationships with Dibane, and planning to take the next castle or the next fief for Sinbad are the goals, not just for this episode, but for the next few episodes to come. So let's go ahead and visit the village elder at Dibane and see if we can help him out with something. Your care of home, the village is always appreciated. Okay, so they want nothing. So that's pretty cool. So we're gonna now go try to find Amir Lachem. Try to avoid as much as we can any fights with the Khergit lords. Sinbad is not a protector of lands, but you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. Your village is under attack. Whoa. So our village is currently being raided. I need to find 50. We can take him. We can take him. He's running from me. He has Nords. Was he a Nord Lord? Okay. So we're being chased by this guy, and there's this guy who was attacking our village. I'm inclined to go and chase this guy down, even though I don't want my relationship with the Khergits overall to go down. So let's look at this faction relation report. You can see that the Khergits and the Serenids are at war, which actually makes the relationship go down by 40. And our relationship is negative 30 with them, so it's not great. The Khergits are only at war with us. I need to pull them away. I need to keep pulling him away. He's trying again, this bastard. What is this? The dance of parties. Oh, yes. No! No! Where did he go? Oh my god, this stupid Rodok guy. Where is the Serenid Lord? They're both raiding it together. What is this? No. My beautiful village. I'm gonna go fight him. I need to get rid of them. Now he's trying to kill the caravan. Maybe the caravan will help us. He is a Nord. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and charge. It is a night battle. Infantry stop here. Cavalry. Whoa, I keep hitting cavalry, I need you to follow me. Infantry, I need you to just charge them. Cav, let's go. We're going around the side. Once our infantry makes contact, we'll charge them in from the side. This way, Cav. Alright, Cav. Charge for the glory of the Serenids! Oh, Oh, my horse got downed. Alright, time to fight on foot. It's going well for us. We're losing a few men, but it's going well. He's trying to run. He's no threat. Parentis advances in level. Alright, there's only one guy left. Alright. So this was always going to be an easy fight for us. But, it wasn't going to be an easy fight with the Rodok. He manages to escape, which is unfortunate. Did lose a horseman, two guards, and an infantry. We can maybe hire this guy. Alright, I'll tell you what we'll do. I'm gonna grab all this stuff. This is actually gonna sell incredibly well. And then I'm gonna start... I'm gonna go to my party here. And let's talk to my companions and see if we can upgrade their equipment. So... Rolf here, his one-handed has got the 32. This one is nice. Can he carry it? Indeed he can. Elite scimitar though. I actually like that. 103 range. I like that a lot. I'm gonna carry that. Sorry, I kinda stole it from him. Okay, so his armor gives him 26 and 7. This is really good. His shield only has a resistance of 1, so he's definitely going to be someone to get one of these better shields. Now let's take a look at Marnid, who actually needs to upgrade some of his skills. Let's buff him his power strike. His crossbowman is really good, so there we go. Now let's take a look at his equipment. Let's give him this one. Yeah, we can upgrade his boots. Now let's do Nissa. She's rocking lance and bow. Wow. She's got a decent shield. She could use better boots. Yeah. Jeremis. Let's check Jeremis out. An armor upgrade. So let's go ahead and give him some gloves. He's running with a war spear. Why does he have this bolt? It's kind of weird. And the last companion is Ferentis, who actually also leveled up. Strength point, and then he's going to get an iron flesh point. I want him to be a better crossbowman a little bit. Pretty good equipment overall. He doesn't have bolts though. There we go. Let's give him a better shield. The village is under attack. Another count is trying to... Oh, this guy. I need to keep... Okay, let's see what he has. He has lots of crossbowmen. 25 crossbowmen is way too much for us to handle, so I'm gonna go get some help. Again, we're not making money from the Khergit businesses. Who's this guy? I think he's a friend. Ukes? No, it's that guy again. God damn it. I need him to follow me. Fuck. We are under attack, but the enemy is repulsed. Indeed. It is Dabien, my village. Okay, he's doing it. He's doing it. He's doing it. He's doing it. He's riding to Dabien. Excellent. We're gonna be able to... Yeah, here we go. Here we go. Yeah! No, he finished raiding it? No, he looted it! No! We were too late! We were too late! No! The people of Dabien waited for Sinbad's arrival. And it was never there. We were too late. So, I'm gonna increase my Serenid Horseman size from 20 to 25. I think we need 6 to do that. And I think we need 2 guards. I'm also gonna increase our guards from 10 to 15. So we need 7. And I'm gonna increase my footmen from 19 to 25. So we need 6 also. The infantry, sorry. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go into Rodak territory, maybe try to find a lord that we can fight, or maybe even better, a castle that we can capture. I like this castle here. It's in close proximity to our current existing castles. So I'm going to go and just check it out and see what's happening here. After consulting with the peers, it's a mere diul. Actually, let's stop and check. So diul is actually really, really like tight with us. So he's going to be... See, it's we've got a good, strong, group of lords who kind of like us. So diul is going to be a great marshal. Especially during this time of war, like, it couldn't have been better. I want to see if this castle is... Let's see what it's like. So there's a count there, and it has a garrison of 263. Alright. So to take it down, we need maybe 500... 400 to 500 men. So I'm gonna now track down again the lord. So Diul, Gullison, and Mundalir. Those are gonna be the three that we need to go and tell to ride towards Almera Castle. So let's go ahead and do that. Bilya, I think we're friends with. Yeah. I will not forget our capture of Unzadek Castle, indeed, friend. Suggest a course of action, a fortress that can be taken at... Where is Almera? I guess we can't... Oh, there it is, Almera. Alright, so he's going to Almera. So we got one guy. Dashwa, let's see if we can recruit him also. No, I don't think he'll listen. I don't think he'll listen to us. Oh, he is going. That's great. Okay, I need to find more lords to recruit to our cause. Does Karaf has anyone in it? No. Huh. Dihul to Jemayid. Oh god, I've sent two lords the exact opposite way. Who's this? Mundalir. Good to see you, friend. Easy. Okay, he's going. So I'm gonna let them head there. First I'm gonna go check out with Dihul. Where is he? He's in here with Lachem. Lachem's party is like... Oh my god, was Lachem taken prisoner? I think Lachem was taken prisoner. We meet again. I heard that you fought and defended Dogna and I'll get heard of him whimpering for mercy indeed. He must have been captured. Here's the marshal. Yes. I have a company. Excellent. Okay, good. So we're gonna accompany him now. But now maybe I can suggest a course of action to him. There's a fortress that can be taken in Almera. I'm sorry, shit. Okay, so he's too busy. I'm gonna go to a nearby town. Oh, damn it. All the towns are Khergit towns. Visit lady. Okay. We're gonna just wait here for a bit. Almera Castle, it is being besieged. I need to go. God damn it. He's starting the siege. I need to finish up with Dihul here as fast as I can and go help with that castle and then hope to lay claim. Hope to lay claim to the castle. Scout the area. Durkaba un castle Kedelke. Alright, I'm gonna do this quest real fast. Should be scouted. Okay, indeed. This village is scouted. And finally, we need Uhun. Uhun castle. Mir Atis has started combat. I need to help him, guys. He's losing. This is... Okay, Atis. Follow me, Cav, follow me. Alright, I need to send my infantry here. Cav is gonna need to follow. Oh my, I keep pressing escape. Oh my god, we're being charged. Okay, infantry, go. Oh my god, the Khergits are insane. Infantry charge. Cav. Oh my god. Cav. Charge. We're close to dying. This was a mistake. This was a mistake. I don't know if we can take these. Look at this guy. This army they have is full of Khergits. The strongest of Khergits. Okay, we seem to be doing well. Oh shit, sorry Mandalir, sorry, I thought you were a Khergit. Oh my god. I don't know what's come of my troops. I really don't know what has come of my own troops. All getting knocked out. Look at the battlefield. There's so much red. There's so much red, guys. This is bad. Oh, no. Yeah, I get to control someone else. This is one of my companions. I believe this is Jeremis. Oh, my goodness. It's Ferentis. It's Ferentis. This was a bad mistake to join this fight. But I couldn't have let him. Would you have just let him die? This strong group of infantry, though. Oh, my dear lord. Oh my dear god. We still have some cav alive. Can I command? I can command. Oh my god, what a kill. Dear me. Cav, go. Alright, I've got reinforcements spawning in. I tried to get the battle sizer to work with this mod, but for some reason it just didn't. Okay, I can now command my infantry to move forward. Infantry joined their infantry. Alright guys, I think the tide is turning. Sinbad may have fallen, but the tide is turning. This is insane. Shield. Oh boy. Yeah, their numbers are dwindling. We are definitely taking the lead. Alright, now I can tell everyone to charge. Get him. Oh yes, there's one red dot left. Oh my goodness. We made it. Sinbad fell. Oh my god, we have lost 9 men total. Our allies lost 16. But they lost so much. 7 left. Sinbad is back into the fight. In the fight, there's 7 guys left. I really honestly thought we were gonna lose that fight, like, big time. I have a feeling Sinbad might be over-encumbered. I'll have to check that out after. Oh, hit friendly troop. Delivered 30 damage. Whew. Alright. So that ends that battle. Turned up just in time. Sinbad, I will not forget your help. We showed those bastards. He managed to escape. We have lots of wounded people. Where's the count? Oh no. The count that was with us has escaped. I cannot help you this time, Attis. You will need to take the fight on your own. The Khergits are closing in hard. Thankfully, we are faster than them. You must go and find the main Serenade group. Here he is. Whoa, he appears to be running. My pleasure. Alright, so now we're starting to lose money. We didn't get any rents from Dubane, and that really... Whoa, what? What? Oh my god, Ahmarad was taken by the Khergits. So wait, what's happening here? Is he besieging it? Hello, Mundalir. Yes, I did. I wish to ask you something. What are you doing? We are besieging Almira Castle. I am completing what I have already begun. I'm not accompanying the Marshal because I can do greater deeds. This is amazing. Okay. Do I have to accompany the Marshal? Yeah, I just need to wait for assignments. This castle's definitely under siege now. I don't know why they're not attacking. Alright, we definitely need to get some Weapon Master, which is an agility trait. So everything all the levels that we're going to be getting is definitely going to be going towards agility. But I'm going to increase my crossbow. I'm going to put all these points in crossbow for now. Because during the battle, I'm going to carry a crossbow into the fight. So siege crossbow, and I'm going to get these steel bolts. Can I make it to Dihrim in time? I need to go to a city so he can buy some food. Shit. I failed the quest. Let me go to the companion management. And access an inventory of my storekeeper. He does have food now, okay. So I needed to just go into a city. Oh, it's one of these huge deserter armies that is starting to become a lot more common than you usually see in Calradia. The fight has yet to begin. What are you waiting for, bro? Are you waiting for them to come? This siege needs to happen. And that's why we're gonna wait. Dibian has been raided. Oh my god, we're being taken so hard by the Khergits. Oh my goodness. Guys, what is happening? To the Khergits! What is happening? It's looted. It's done. The Serenids are being pushed. Their face is being pushed in by these Khergit dogs. Oh my god. I'm gonna go for this battle. I need to weaken their presence. This was the guy. Look at his armor. Need to charge and be decisive. Oh my god, we're in the sand dunes. Infantry here, cavalry follow me. Let's go. A welcoming shot. I want the infantry to move here. Alright. see. Shield wall. Alright, infantry, go forward. Cav, let's do it. We will show them. Alright, Cav. Hit them now. Our infantry is cresting the hill. This is a Vhagar army. One shot kill on their lord. That's what I'm talking about. This is a massacre. Oh my god, that almost took me out. Have we lost anyone? I don't think we've lost anyone. Why are they still following me? Cav, charge. This is a Swadian. Oh, it's a mercenary Cav. The sands have won us the day. There's one horseman left. It's very interesting that there are all these lords now that are factionless and they're joining the strong faction. They're also hiring lots of mercenaries. Vhagar Knight. Sinbad has been bloodied this day. Oh, we did lose one. Alright guys, so this has been an action-packed episode for Sinbad and his party. If we go ahead and take a look at the personal reports and look at our budget, you will quickly see that we're not making the money that we should be making at all. In fact, we're losing money now as we travel and as we fight. The main reason for that is that four of our businesses have been sequestrated by the Khergits, who are expanding and growing rapidly. We need to take a castle for ourselves now. Otherwise, we might as well just have to leave the Serenids and give up on Lady Sophia and our dreams of being a Serenid lord with a castle and just join the Khergits. But our relationship with the Khergits has been pretty good, given that we have always been traveling and trading within their territory. But now that we're having to fight their lords, it's starting to deteriorate for Sinbad and his crew. His popularity isn't as good as it would be. And you can see that our dye works at Suno have been suffering because of the lack of trips of dyes and the lack of supplies. So, next episode, we're going to try to finish up this siege and see what we can do about pushing the Khergit horde back. If it doesn't work, Sinbad is going to be in trouble. Stay tuned for episode number 13 to see what happens to Sinbad and his crew. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you all next time. Take care.